outdated roster, especially ever since 05 when the original Raw vs. SmackDown became available for the first time on the original PlayStation 2. I think that what we're seeing now, what we've seen over the last 7 or 8 years, is an updated roster with one or two new moves added to your move arsenal, and a few new storylines thrown in there. TNA Impact, the video game, is not a substitute for it. It's funny how TNA hasn't released another video game since TNA Impact, with every wrestler having the same move set. Video games now are just absolute shit now. I mean, they're not fun to play anymore. You know, I just almost wish there was a way I could play the original WWF WrestleMania as the Ultimate Warrior and Hulk Hogan at my local arcade. Because now, the video games aren't fun anymore. It's the same thing every year. And now that Acclaim has made this, or THQ, excuse me, has made this revolutionary announcement that they're calling it, releasing WWE 12 for the first time, I think if you're going to release a game, as I said here previously, for this week's audio commentary, the way you need to release it is release WWE 1300, because it's just well to now put numbers on each individual WWE video game from the past, even back as far as the original Raw on Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis. The good thing about Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis were they'd release the same video game title, but the Sega Genesis video game would be a little bit different from the Super Nintendo video game, so that offered a little bit of differentiality and a bit of competition factor. But now with WWE eliminating the competition factor in recent years between Raw and SmackDown, more so than what we saw when the brand extension first kicked off with wars between the show and the competition element in full swing, I think THQ sees no point in releasing a Raw versus SmackDown video game because we don't see the brands going head to head as much as we did in previous installments of the game. We see them go head to head each year at bragging rights, but with there only being two installments of bragging rights in WWE history where Raw and SmackDown would compete for a trophy and bragging rights for an entire year, I think that THQ sees no point in releasing another Raw vs. SmackDown video game. They see a point in trying something new that hasn't been done before, but they have no purpose in releasing a Raw vs. SmackDown video game and aren't making it their top priority. Maybe a sequel to WWE All-Stars will come over the next 365 days in 1 year period. But with everything going on in WWE right now, them eliminating the competition between Raw and SmackDown, that factor being eliminated, I think that what we're going to see from THQ in the terms of WWE video game releases is going to be something entirely different, something we haven't seen before in the past, but I'm not getting my hopes up on that one. I will not be picking up a copy of WWE 12. I haven't picked up any copies of the recent WWE video games. I'm an old school wrestling fan who loves the old school video games. And maybe there's a listener to this program who is an old-school wrestling fan themselves and enjoyed seeing the Undertaker-Kane feud from 2010, who enjoyed seeing The Last Stand of D-Generation X back in 2010. But I think that the WWE 12 video game is going to be something entirely different from what we have seen. But I'm not getting my hopes up on that one. I don't think I'll be standing in line waiting for midnight to purchase it like some people did for the release of Mortal Kombat, the latest installment of that video game, which was very popular on PlayStation and Xbox 360. Mortal Kombat probably will end up selling more copies when the video game sales reports are released by the Billboard charts and stuff. I think that Mortal Kombat is going to outdo WWE anytime. You know, the did you know facts about how WrestleMania 27 outsold things like Harry Potter and the Deadly Hallows Part 1 and Justin Bieber Never Say Never. I don't know if I believe that, and I don't know if the WWE video game is going to outsell things like Mortal Kombat, which was a bestseller. I'm not putting my hopes up on that. I'm not betting anything like my life or swearing on my mother's grave about it because I don't want to, go out on a limb and say that WWE 12 is going to outsell another installment of Mortal Kombat, which will probably come in the next year. But the unbelievable video game titles they are releasing, like this L.A. Noire video game for PlayStation 3, has unbelievable graphics, and Red Dead Redemption has unbelievable graphics, and Just the game titles they're releasing seem so lifelike from what they were 5 years ago. You know, they are unbelievably real. So real that it almost feels like you're in the game. It feels like you're part of something spectacular, more so than you felt, you know. It creates somewhat of a feel like the virtual Game Boy did back in the 90s, which was the closest thing to reality you could get. But it creates a feel that is unbelievable, and I think that WWE will never be able to beat this feel of realism. I don't think they've ever been able to have that for any previous video game title they've released, and I don't think they ever will. They're never going to be able to compete with Rockstar Games. They're never going to be able to compete with any popular video game title like GoldenEye, the GoldenEye series. The Grand Theft Auto series will always outsell them. Even the video game The Godfather, which was released years ago, and even the Mafia series, I think that they're going to find it very difficult to outsell video games like L.A. Noire and you know, the top video games that are out there now. And you can go to IGN.com for more information on upcoming video game releases and any information they have on WWE 12 and how THQ and WWE are going to be approaching this. Obviously, on WWE programming, they'll have a lot of screenshots by the end of the year, airing on Raw and SmackDown, promoting the video game and trying to influence you to buy it. But I don't know if a lot of people are going to want to go out and buy it, given the game title. It's not catchy to me. I don't enjoy, you know, knowing that the game, I don't take enjoyment knowing that the game is called WWE 12. I don't expect anything huge to come from WWE 12. And the people who are looking forward to the video game release of WWE 12, I think, are going to be severely let down. The amount of talent you're going to be able to access in the video game is going to be outstanding. But the two things that you need to look for when it comes to especially a WWE video game release are good gameplay and good storylines and good graphics. And hopefully WWE 12 will deliver on all of those elements, and it will come through on being a good WWE video game release and probably the highest selling video game in WWE history. No doubt it will make it onto WWE's Did You Know Facts that air between Raw and SmackDown on commercial breaks, which serve no purpose. But hopefully something good will come of WWE 12. So on that note, I'm not expecting, my expectations are not high for WWE 12 to be released by THQ at the end of this year. But I hope you fans aren't let down like you have been in the past, especially over the last 7 or 8 years. If you want my honest opinion, find an old WWE video game and like Raw or WWF Royal Rumble, and somehow get your hands on a Super Nintendo or a Sega Genesis, and you'll have the time of your life. Send us your opinion on WWE Raw vs. SmackDown and the up-and-coming WWE 12 through MySpace, Facebook, and YouTube. Subscribe, send us friends requests, and interact with us in our radio form, and send us a traditional email, hewwrestling@hotmail.com, with your opinion included and information on how we can get a hold of you. And if we like your opinion, we might even share it here with our listening audience out in our radio form. This show is heard in our radio form on our official website throughout the internet. I'm Jonathan Clark. This week we took a look at THQ making the announcement that they're dropping the Raw vs. SmackDown title from their video game releases that pertain and involve WWE. Kind of a mixed reaction. I'm kind of shocked about it, but I talked about it for this week's audio commentary, and this will be available on YouTube, and I'm hoping and predicting that it's going to get a lot of reviews and hits. But until next week, I'm Jonathan Clark saying stay safe no matter where you are in the world. Keep enjoying wrestling because, as always, it's an ever-evolving sport where there's always going to be something new and innovative to talk about. And hopefully next week we'll talk about something more important than a pointless video game release. Find us on MySpace, Facebook, and YouTube. Send us friends requests and subscription requests, and we'll get in touch with you as soon as possible. Enjoy the rest of your evening, and we'll check in with you next week. For HEW Entertainment Variety Radio, I'm Jonathan Clark, and I'll see you very soon.
Jellystone Park, one of the nation's oldest and most beautiful stretches of wilderness. For years, families have headed out from the busy city, eager to enjoy a little camping, fishing, and of course, observing the park's natural wildlife.
Boo-boo, I think it's time I introduce myself to that picnic basket.
You know, Yogi, we could just hunt for food. All the other animals do.
Boo-boo, a picnic basket has everything a bear needs. And I'm not just talking about the treats and snack-type goodies. No, a picnic basket holds a lot more than that. It holds dreams.
I was thinking more along the lines of ice cream, candies, cookies, and cakes. And come to think of it, it all started with a dream for me some 12 years ago. I wanted to interview wrestlers. That was something that I wanted to accomplish in this life. And I did it. I wanted to interview celebrities, and I did it. I wanted to interview independent bands and independent actors, and I did it. I wanted to reach out to all of you, and I did it. However, when it comes to making a peanut butter and jelly sandwich and putting together a picnic basket and keeping it away from the world's smarter than an average bear, I don't know if I'm cut out for that. You're listening to HEW Entertainment Variety Radio with me, Jonathan Clark, reminding you to not feed the bears.
Hook me in!
You sure it'll work, Yogi?
Well, you know, Boo-Boo, I'm smarter than the average bear!
All right!
When something takes place in the world of professional wrestling, you know where to go. WrestleZone.com. WrestleZone.com.